You have enough from sleepless nights, suffering or being afraid. You have enough from feeling the pain of project execution. You are still losing against second-class competitors. The key question is how you can change this. The answer is Metis. Connect perfectly the office with the construction site. Have real-time information at your fingertips. Therefore, you will make based on facts best decisions. Enjoy your free time, stressless, and be the hero in execution of your EPC projects, industrial projects, shutdowns, and piping works. You simplify your plant construction life. Learn more in this video and contact us now. Hello again. So now I show you today in this video something useful for piping works. We have already here as the basis for each piping work is the line list, and as you can see here I already imported a line list. You have also the possibility to create additional lines or to make revisions for some lines, and you have here always the last status in front that you know which pipelines you have currently in your projects. This is the basis then also to go further for isometric management. And in isometric management, you can either create or import all of your isometrics. And when we look here in the edit, you can see here all the data which relate to an isometric. Furthermore, you can here then attach files if you want, and here you have a working history. The working history is interesting because here you can follow up which team is doing what to which status in the projects. And this status here is also one of the bases to make progress reporting. There are several options, but it's one possibility. Here you can add spools. For example, let's say spool A, and I will show what's going to do with this. In the section here is a spool management section where you see all of the spools in your projects. Currently I have just a few there as it's a demo project, and here you can see which is on hold, or on a very fast basis you can here just with a click update, and you know always the status of each spool. Here under isometric management, you can also enter where is stored the spool, which team stored it, when was it taken over, and on this way can be avoided a lot of searching times in the field. So until it's finished here, we go now back to isometric management to show you more there. When we are here, this was the edit, you can delete it, you can create revisions. In the revisions will be always saved the status, the drawings, and the data of the last revision. So you will always have the full track on it. Here, this is also revision control for the parts to see better how the parts developed. And what you have also here is the part list itself. Here, for example, for this pipeline, a part list, and in the end, you see also what is the status on material, which you have on stock, which is missing, and whatsoever. When we go one time back, before we will make here, you have under isometric management also this function of calculate, where you can calculate on several methods the best prefabrication or the best erection, depending on different methods, either on dia inch or weights, if you want to have to, you can say if you want to have some special pressure tests considered, or different other options that you have here. Now we will go to the part list again, and of course you can request from here material. Let's say we will just request for the moment the last position, the pipe, the 20-inch pipe, and we create a request. Of course, all is then also saved here under the PDF, and you have always here the track of what you have requested, and the tool itself have also a material management application. And here, for example, you have all the requests you have sent. Here under projects parts, you have all of the parts which are there, and you can enter what you have on stock, or you can enter the procurement value. You see what is procured, what is not procured, how many you have on stock. So for the pipe now, we will make a setup. I choose the theme what we have. Here we have just one item on stock and the user we don't need, the pickup date we make. And we should note here, for example, the heat number. Please remember this heat number of heat pipe 20 and certificate number. And we will take this off now, because this is connected to the welding management. When we go here under welds, you automatically, all isometrics are coming here, and so you see here already some data seen, the rest is currently empty. You can put here how much you want to test in your for this isometric, and here then you have all the welds mentioned. You see here I already welded some welds. Either you can create a new weld here with all of the positions, or what is quite good, you can simply duplicate here, giving a new weld number. If you want to change something here to, let's say, butt weld, then we change it here. Now I show you something else. Here the WBS, it's in the system, all of your WBS, and you can connect them. Here also the filler material 2, let's say, what we need. And now here you can see from the part list what you want to connect. For example, we want to have this pipe 508. And we connect it with, I don't have a second item here which is proper, let's say also with a pipe 508. And now when you have chosen this, you see you can get automatically the heat number of this part, what you have taken over. This means you have a full traceability from the receiving of your material until the reaction, so that the of the heat number and the certificates. And when we say here yes, we need to go to the second page, because we have given this number 11. You can see here all of the data, and of course you saw maybe before the PDF section, you can print out in the welding documentation. Here these are the fields for the testing, and I will show you all welded welds come here in this section of current welds, and it will remain there for 7 days. Then automatically it will go under archived welds, so you will have always your welds mentioned here. And we have here now this weld number 11. It's a butt weld. We see the filler material, the weld size, and I can here, for example, say I want to do a RT and I want to do visual test, let's say, and I will make a request. I will see here if I want to have them. So now I can say, for example, which companies I want to choose for making the test. Let's say now, yes, I'm sure I want to request the test. And so now comes all here on the NDT welds. And in order to make it quite fast, if I put here the real testing date, let's say also here, and a 13 number 23, and here also, let's say, a certificate number 55. No repairs, nothing. I can add here files. Then, and let's say it's closed, it's done. Then in my welding documentation, here, under weld 11, I get here already the certificate numbers mentioned and also the tests and if it's a repair or not, I can change it also here in this case if I want. And all comes here to documentation. In documentation, I have an overview about the welding status. I have all the isometrics here. I can see how much total die inch I have to weld, what I have currently welded, some butt weld on erection. I see also my repair quote here for the different things. Here in the second section, I see the testing overview, how much I have should tested, either for one isometric or in total, and how much I really have and what is open, all of this. And in the end, finally, I get here also status about the welder, how much each welder have welded, what is his repair quote, and whatsoever. This was now related to welding. Some other useful tools for piping are maybe the pressure test planning. Here I have already one pressure test circuit included. When I open them, I can here attach files, I have different field tiers, I can add my appliance to each pressure test, I can add the removed items for each pressure test, it comes automatically the connected isometrics and I can see the status of the isometric and if something doesn't fit, let's say from the pressure test circuit data with the isometric data, then it's coming here in red. And the work history of each pressure test so that I can really complete then my project fast as possible. And as a special feature, I can say here if I want to have here a signature, maybe also here on client, then when I save it and I look in the related PDF, then it gives me the PDF already with my signatures. And this means I can sign in the field the pressure test certificate when I have done it. Other feature here about die-in, it's nothing there, but I can put here all of my die-ins, what we have to do. So really to have track also on the execution of your die-ins. There are a lot of other features as you have seen, but I consider them as the most important one. Features for the piping part. Ah, maybe one more, maybe the calculation. When you have a price list and when you have a part list, then automatically for each isometric comes automatically the calculation for it. And also when you do a weld, then it's going to shown here. And I can put here the percent finished also for each item. And this is then also one methodology for the progress reporting. And I see how much house I have calculated. And there are some other reports then that are quite helpful for managing of your piping project. So this was a fast first showing of the software. I hope you could have a little bit an idea what Metis can do for you and hope to see you soon. Hello, this is Franz again. I hope you liked the video. But most important is what you really need. What brings you and your business forward. Therefore, contact me now and we will cost-free analyze what you really need. See you soon and a lot of successful projects. You simplify your plant construction life.